referee Kim Ching gets us underway. Lumbung goal with the blue tape around her gloves, left of screen. Limbaga, red tape around her gloves, right of screen. Southpaw stance here on both ladies.
Lumbung goal's got a really nice push kick. You can see her threatening it there. Trying to create a little bit of space. You can see Limbaga changing back and forth between stances, now coming out of southpaw.
Limbaga, the Filipino. Lumbung goal from Indonesia. Circles on the outside, just Limbaga. Good solid Muay Thai inside leg kick from her. Southpaws love to throw the inside leg kick. Left hook, straight cross. I should say right hook, straight cross there from the southpaw. They clinch up against the fence for the very first time.
That's what Lumbung goal wanted. She wanted to press her up against the cage, look for that body clinch, now go for the takedown. She likes the outside trips.
Looks for a trip takedown there. Does Lumbung goal? Can she get top position? Will she take the back here of Limbaga? She does indeed.
Limbaga's got to be careful. She's got the headlock. If Lumbung goal pops her head out, she's got the back.
Determined contest from these two young ladies in the opening 1 minute 20 of this first round, set for 3.
Limbaga's trying to use the headlock takedown to get her down, but she's got a good grip on that head. She just might have it here.
Limbaga hunting for the finish on Lumbung goal. As Lumbung goal's back still, Mitch.
She's got one hook in. If she can just slide her head out. Now she's fighting the hand there. She's going to try to pop the head out. She's going to have the back. Limbaga's not giving up that head, though. Oh, just like that. Now she's got the back. Limbaga's got to try to get back up. She's got to defend the hands first. Be careful. Watch that right leg of Lumbung goal so she doesn't get both hooks in.
This really is a very good contest between two ladies who really we thought may have stayed on the feet for a lot longer, Mitch.
She was fighting the hands, but now Lumbung goal's got one hand under the neck. She's a little bit high on the back. Limbaga might be able to pop out the backside.
And Lumbung goal flattened her out here, still has the back of Limbaga, or can she pancake her? Referee Kim Ching right on top of the action. Lumbung goal still has the back. She may be starting to flatten her out. No, not yet.
Well, I like how she got rid of that leg there. She's got to be careful not to trap the arm like that. She reached under the leg to try to get a little bit of space. Now she lets go of it. Now she's still fighting the hands.
Lumbung goal drives a knee into the backside, still trying to form a choke here on Limbaga.
Good defense. The defense of Limbaga has improved. She's doing the right stuff. She's defended the hooks first. First she defended the hands, and now she got the hooks out. Now she can work to stand back up.
What sort of damage do the knees do from here?
They can do a little bit of damage, but she's not really able to create a lot of space and drive the hips in, so it's more annoying than anything else. But she is scoring with the judges as well. They're seeing a lot of control in this position, and they're starting to see a little bit of damage. But you can see Limbaga's got the hand defended, but Lumbung is trying to go under again.
The Indonesian having a dominant first round so far, but Limbaga back to her feet, and here come the knees from the Muay Thai stylist. Takedown attempt from Priscilla Hertati Lumbung goal. Top position now.
She's got half guard. Limbaga can't give up that leg. Oh, Lumbung goal was able to slide that left leg out, back to the headlock. Trying to pin down the arm with a crucifix here. She's trying to trap Limbaga's left arm there underneath her legs.
Look at the determination here from Priscilla Hertati Lumbung goal, and Limbaga surviving. No, she's gone now.
Is that a straight arm lock?
Priscilla Hertati Lumbung goal taps out Crystal Limbaga in the first round. What an epic round. Two contests in the space of a month, and two brilliant performances from Priscilla Hertati Lumbung goal.
That was an arm bar, Michael. She used the legs. She shoved the arm in between her legs and caught a straight arm bar there with the legs. That was very tricky there, Michael.
Have a look at it again here. Walk us through this, Mitch.
Lumbung goal was able to secure the takedown. That was the first takedown. That wasn't where she finished the job. But there she can see her trying to get to the back. The ground game of Lumbung goal has definitely improved by leaps and bounds. Here's some of those knees. Not a big knee, but scored a little bit of points. Then we saw that she was able to get the headlock, and from the headlock position, here's the armbar coming up. She shoves the arm between her legs, hyperextends the hip. Look at her hips. Her hips are extending. That's a straight arm lock right there. Beautifully done by Lu Bangol.
Absolutely beautifully done by Priscilla Hitotati Lu Bangol. So another display, another showing there of a wushu stylist who has brought the ground game into her complete martial arts game. Here's Dominic.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the medal for this match, we have Telenor Myanmar. And now, your referee, Mr. Kemp Chang, has put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 5 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of armbar, Priscilla Herati Lumangao!
She may be the most active competitor in one championship, and she's certainly the most impressive in 2018 so far. 2-0 this year, and we're still in February. Priscilla Hitotati Lu Bangol.
Go!
Rika Ishigai in the black and pink, the white trunks on Antonia.
Look at Antonia immediately starting to swarm on her. Yeah, Rika Ishigai has got to clinch up. She's getting a little bit bewildered when she starts taking some of these shots. She's got to move. She can't stand there in the pocket.
Two-time Myanmar national boxing champion, Atomweight, also a member of the Burmese national Lithway team. Lithway, the national sport of Myanmar. Very similar to Kung Khmer and Muay Thai. Here come the hands again. She's opened up like a house on fire. Has bolts in Atomweight.
Yeah, Rika Ishigai was clinching, though. You know, Antonia started landing some big shots there, but Rika Ishigai went to the clinch, started landing those knees, got the crowd a little bit behind her there with a little bit of Muay Thai technique.
That took bear from Rika Ishigai, began her martial arts career in Aikido and Karate at 13 years old. She looks for a takedown of Antonia here, and she gets it.
Beautiful body lock there. I was waiting for her to shoot that takedown because you could see Antonia started letting go of those hands, and Rika Ishigai was taking them, but she went to the body lock, went to the outside trip, got this right to where she wanted. Oh, nice little defense there. Rika Ishigai tried to go to the mount, but Antonia was able to stop one of them, but now she's on top again.
And this is Rika's world. Ishigai does have a 100% finishing rate.
Antonia trying her big bridge. Good defense here from Rika Ishigai to managing to stay there on top.
Rika did say she wanted to finish this bout quickly. She is actually carrying an injury in her right leg, a ligament injury. Said she wanted to take her down and finish her in the first round so the leg doesn't get beaten up too much. This crowd going nuts here in Bangkok. It is deafening for Rika Ishigai. Can she find the finish in the first round? There's the body triangle now from Rika. The tiny doll in control.
Antonia's got to, first he's got to worry about the hands. You know, she's good, doing a good job here. If you want to defend the body triangle, you have to go to the side that the feet are crossed on. So you can see her applying pressure to that right side of the leg. So it's going to be a little more difficult. There it goes. It opens up. Rika Ishigai transitions around. Antonia needs to spin. She needs to create a little bit of separation. Get flattened out like this.
His butler out like a pancake now. Here's the ground and pound. Antonia not defending. She's in trouble. Yuji Shimada won't stop this one. Yes, he does. Rika's back in the winner's circle.
Wow, Rika Ishigai. I think she found that switch, Rich Franklin.
I think you're right this time. You know, the first takedown attempt that she tried to do, she was kind of shucked off. But the second takedown attempt, she got in there tight with the body lock and said, this is not going to happen to me. Once she got on top, she had great hip pressure all the way through. Side mount, all the different positions that she was maneuvering through. Kept herself heavy, and it was just a textbook flow from start to finish all the way to, you can see it here.
Oh, look at the tiny doll showing that aggression and did not hesitate one single bit. Applied that hip pressure and let it go.
I hate to tell you, but I think she's still smiling here.
A win will do that.
bringing the house down. Riku Ishige, as a massive crowd continues to file into the mighty Impact Arena in Bangkok, Thailand. Rika flattened out Molzina Antonia and simply pounded on her till Yuji Shimada said no more. There's Ann Osman for Global Citizen. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Ann Osman, Global Citizen Ambassador. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 48 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Rika Ishige!
For the tiny doll, Rika Ishige, the winner's medal stays here in Bangkok.
Ready? Go!
Chabuli there from Lachkova. High kick from the Russian. Yamaguchi possesses a beautiful overhand right. And with a tall opponent like Lachkova, well, it's tailor-made for that overhand.
Especially because that overhand right is also going to put her in a perfect position to snatch up a single leg as well. So watch for that. Watch her throw that overhand right, drop down, grab that single, turn into a takedown.
Jab right there from Lachkova. An 80% finishing rate for the Russian on a 5-bout winning streak tonight. Yamaguchi, who twice fired unsuccessfully for the Atomweight World title, both times came agonizingly close to defeating Angela Lee. You'll see Lee later on tonight shooting for the strawweight world title against Zhong Jinan.
Good takedown defense so far from Lachkova. Able to keep that over-under position, back her up against the cage and separate.
No sign of nerves on Ksenia Lachkova this week around the hotel and all the media engagements. Very comfortable, very relaxed. Comes in with a very good reputation. Just a filling out process at the moment here for both Lachkova and Yamaguchi. Jab two there from Lachkova, sitting behind the reach. How does Mei Yamaguchi overcome the height differential here, Mitch?
She's got to get, first of all, she's got to try to get into that range. She's got to try to get into that boxing range for her. She can start throwing some of these hands. She's having a hard time dealing with the range of Lachkova, and Lachkova's doing a good job of keeping her at bay with that jab and keeping that distance off. Watch the footwork of Lachkova. Every time you can see Mei Yamaguchi trying to close that distance, Lachkova's moving out and throwing that right hand of hers. She's not throwing any kicks either. She's not giving Mei Yamaguchi a chance to catch any kicks, and she's throwing just hands at this point.
Even though we are sold out here at the Rio Gokokoku Gigan, very quiet. The Japanese are renowned as the most educated martial arts fans in the world. They sit there, they soak it all in, all the techniques, and their deep appreciation for the martial arts. In what many people believe and call, amongst myself, the spiritual home of the martial arts. And it's great to have one championship here for the very first time. Single leg lock on from Mei Yamaguchi.
Good job by Mei Yamaguchi to get connected here as she approaches that single leg. She was finally able to duck under some of these punches from Lachkova, close that distance, grab onto that single leg. Look how Lachkova's got that overhook on her right side. She's trying to keep the posture nice and high so Mei Yamaguchi's not able to drop down, change levels, and at least try to circle around and get that double leg. There she goes, trying to get that double leg. Now her hands are almost locked. Lachkova's doing a good job of keeping her legs separated and also using the overhooks to control the posture of Yamaguchi and not enable her to drop down and lock those hands together. The defense, technically, from Lachkova.
Big hello to all of our Japanese viewers watching tonight on TV Tokyo and Abema TV. Championship, the very first time in Japan. Turn around here from Lachkova, backs Yamaguchi against the fence, crossing elbow from the Russian. Now it's Yamaguchi's turn, nicely done from Vivi.
can see, Yamaguchi has both underhooks. She's got two arms underneath the arms of Lachkova. And Lachkova has such good balance in that reach advantage, height advantage, she's able to stop a lot of the takedown attempts by Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi has to keep her back pressed up against the cage there, or Lachkova would have taken her back. Good job.
And there's the appreciation from the crowd here in Tokyo. Lachkova, who is renowned as a first-round finisher, three first-round finishers, has not come out as explosively tonight as we've seen her in the past. But this is her step up to the biggest stage of all, the largest martial arts organization in the world, one championship. And she's handling herself very well, I might say, Mitch.
Yeah, she's able to stop a lot of the takedown attempts, and that is a category of our judges' scoring, is takedown defense. And you can see how she's able to do it. You can see just then, Yamaguchi came in with the overhand right, tried to drop down that single leg, and Lachkova was able to spin her around, press her up against the cage, and now is doing very well inside the clinch.
20 seconds remains. There's the right hand. Now loading it up is Mei Yamaguchi. Traditional martial artist out of Japan against the Pancration World Champion. Takedown there. Final 10 seconds. Yamaguchi on her back. Elbows to the top of the head there from VV Mei Yamaguchi. 1 foot on hips, and that's how the round ends. It's wow. One championship, a new era, live from the Ryogoku Kokugikan in Tokyo, Japan.
Very impressive finish. Look at this, Mei Yamaguchi trying that overhand right. And look at that, she's able to keep her shoulder nice and tight to her chin and was able to deflect a lot of that power coming from Mei. But then, here in the exchange, Mei Yamaguchi lands that short left hand, but Lachkova, the towering kickboxer, was able to throw that overhand right and touch Yamaguchi on the chin. But more significantly, Lachkova was able to score a big takedown at the very end of that round and end the round in a very dominant position. Now, we don't score round by round, but at the first 5 minutes, Lachkova is looking very sharp in all the different areas.
We're ready to roll, second round of three between Ksenia Lachkova and VV Mei Yamaguchi. A magnificent scene inside this incredible building. The Kokugikan, renowned as the Sumo Arena here in Japan. Its colored hallways have been walked by some incredible martial arts champions. Tonight, many of them on display, over 130 martial arts world champions in one championship. Yamaguchi comes up firing with the right hand. Inside leg kick, missed the target. Counter there from Lachkova.
This is what Mei Yamaguchi has to do. She has to make this dirty. She can't allow Lachkova to stand at her range and touch her up with those hands. She's got to get close. She's got to make it dirty. Throw that right hand. That's it. Get nice and tight now. How can she do it? She's got to change levels, drop down, tack that single leg. Good defense from Lachkova. The way she's able to utilize these overhooks to control the position of Yamaguchi is very impressive. Yamaguchi is incredibly strong inside the clinch. Again, she's a judo black belt.
Inside leg there, drops down, locks onto a single leg. Does Yamaguchi, can she affect the takedown? Can she get the Russian on her back? It was Yamaguchi who was on her back at the end of the opening round. As Mitch said, Lachkova doing a lot right so far here tonight.
See, she's utilizing that underhook to keep Mei Yamaguchi posture nice and high and keep her from dropping down. She's even trying to lace these legs and go for the takedown. Lachkova might have grabbed the takedown there. Might have stopped the takedown by grabbing the fence, but eventually Yamaguchi was able to get it.
Close guard from Ksenia Lachkova. 3:20 remains. Second round of three. Throws that close guard up a little higher now, does Lachkova. Let's see if Mei can posture up, break it open, land some ground and pound. Postures up now, does Mei, the hands are locked up for the moment. Tries to get the right hand free, wants a hammer fist strike. And again, close guard opens and closes it again, does Lachkova.
You can see Lachkova's trying to pin down one of these arms, look for an armbar. Yep, there she goes, throw the hips up. And as we see, this is a big high on the arm. You can see the elbow is almost out. She might be able to pop it out, but she's got to, you know, because of the length of Lachkova, she's able to attack a lot of these positions.
And that predicament is Mei Yamaguchi. still top position here for the Japanese martial artist. Good right hand there from Yamaguchi. Snake bang on the schnoz of Lachkova. Then goes to the body.
Lachkova's got a very active guard. You can see her. She's always trying to look for something. She's trying to pin down these arms, trying to lock one of those arms into place so she can start throwing those legs up.
Lachkova eats another right hand.
Good job from Mei Yamaguchi to control that top position. Not putting herself in any big danger, but she is starting to land some ground and pound as well.
Where does Lachkova go from here, Dragon?
I'd like to see Lachkova keep attacking these arms, keep attacking this arm like this. She's trying to pin down that arm like that, and she's going to try to go try to swing one of these legs over and attack another arm bar again. Mei Yamaguchi is not going to make a mistake by putting her hands on the ground and give Lachkova the ability to shoot a triangle. But what we are seeing is, I'd like to see Lachkova just separate here, put the feet on the hips of Mei Yamaguchi and start to push her away. But she keeps hunting for that arm bar.
Hammer fist there from Yamaguchi from inside the closed guard of Lachkova. Ooh, goes to the bread basket. One up to the chest there from Yamaguchi. Three levels in three punches there from Mei Yamaguchi. 1 minute 15 remains. Little peppering shots on the side of the jaw there from Mei. And Lachkova looks to clump towards her corner. They're giving her instructions here, the Russian.
Skova's looking for the finish. She's trying to throw those legs up. See how high her guard is? She's looking for this, but Mei Yamaguchi's not making really any mistakes to give Lachkova the opportunity to throw that submission in.
Yamaguchi, one of six Japanese competitors on tonight's card. Can she give Team Japan a great start here inside the Rio Goku Kokugikan for one championship, a new era? Hiroki Akimoto up next, Senzo Ikeda later on. Of course, Ken Hasegawa still coming. So Yuya Wakamatsu against Demetrius Johnson. Big lineup, big night for Japan. Two punches, then one to the bread basket from Mei Yamaguchi. Do have another Russian on the card too later on in the form of Timofey Nastukin taking on Eddie Alvarez. Don't sleep on Nastukin when he goes beast mode. Eddie Alvarez had better keep his hands up.
Good ground and pound coming from Mei Yamaguchi. Very calculated strategy here on the ground. She's picking her shots and she's doing just enough work to stop the stand-up from Kemp Chang. Here's that takedown that she was finally able to get. Beautiful double leg.
Wherever you're watching around the world, it is the biggest card in history. One championship, a new era. In Tokyo, Japan, third and final round here between Mei Yamaguchi and Ksenia Lachkova. How do you see it so far, Dragon?
It's pretty close at this point. There was a lot of effective ground and pound coming from Yamaguchi. I think at this point, it's gonna come down to these last 5 minutes on who can turn it up the most and clinch this victory in one of the biggest cards in history.
Jab two there from Lachkova. Seemed to be a bit more gusto from Yamaguchi coming out of her corner. Can she get on the inside of the reach of Lachkova? Maybe find range with that overhand right. There it is. Just caught the shoulder though, the lead shoulder of the Russian.
See, watch how Lachkova's stance is. She's always bringing her left shoulder nice and close to her chin, and that's been able to deflect a lot of the shots from Yamaguchi.
Completely different builds between these two martial artists. Counter right hand there from Yamaguchi, throws the right down the corridor again.
And that right hand was able to connect because Lachkova switched to southpaw and it opened her up for that shot.
Yamaguchi wants to drop down, see if she can take Lachkova onto her back. Move right down the court. One score there from Yamaguchi. Crowd response to it. Now starting to find Wayne with the right hand. There's a double one from Yamaguchi. And a takedown. I love it. Inside the Rio Goku Kokugikan.
Now Yamaguchi's starting to feel the moment. And she's realizing that this is still her match to get. And she's able to do a lot of good work here in the third round.
Yamaguchi.
Beautiful right hands landed by Yamaguchi.
Top position here as she ended out the previous round. Little hammer fist there from Yamaguchi. Locking down the wrists is Lachkova.
another one there to the orbital. 3 minutes and five remains. Third and final round, Russia versus Japan. As Lachkova tries to lock on for an arm.
Russia finally able to get it. She was looking for it the entire time, but it looks like Yamaguchi is able to use Lachkova's attempt at a triangle to get the pass, and now sits inside side control.
Over the shot ahead. And this crowd sold out already here in San Dario Goku Kokugigan is loving it every time Yamaguchi lands.
Man, typically, Michael, the Japanese crowds are so quiet, but even their sense of the moment, the magnitude of this card, and they're getting into it.
Since this card was announced, I believe it was last October, the buzz has been incredible. And over the last week, it has reached fever pitch here in Tokyo.
Nice ground and pound still coming from VV Mei Yamaguchi. Now she's sitting in half guard, and Lachkova's got to do something to get back up. She's got about 2 minutes to work. Yamaguchi's got heavy top pressure at this point. Now she's trying to pin her left leg on the thigh of Lachkova, and what she's going to try to do is try to slide her right leg through the half guard just like that and sit into mount and take the back possibly here of Lachkova looking for an arm bar.
Yamaguchi, is she going to tap her out? In the third and final round. Down in the Rio Goku Kokugika.
Wow, that was beautiful. Mei Yamaguchi was able to find the finish. It didn't happen in the first, but it eventually happened in the third. Beautiful finish. Submission victory for VV Mei Yamaguchi in her hometown of Tokyo, Japan. Inside the guard. Look at this, ducks under the punches coming from Lachkova, chases down the double leg, and then she was able to slide through the guard. There she has landed a big knee to soften Lachkova up in side control. She passed into mount. You can see Lachkova extending the arms, gift wrapping the arm bar. Mei Yamaguchi takes it home like Christmas and gets the finish. Look at this adjustment. There's the thumb. Watch the thumb. The thumb has to stay up. There's no place for Lachkova to go except to tap her way out. Beautiful win from Mei Yamaguchi.
Let's go to Tom Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 18 seconds in the third and final round for your winner by way of armbar, Mei Yamaguchi!
There are six Japanese warriors on tonight's card. Yamaguchi is the first, Aoki will be the final, and it's one from one for Team Japan in Tokyo.
Hi, judge time.
She's 2-1, ready? But she's ready? Facing the 4-0 Jenny Huang, who is improving with every fight. Very cautious approach to the center of the cage from Huang, whereas Asinio looks all action, doesn't she? On her toes, bouncing up and down.
Yeah, she's got that nice, light style of wushu. They like to attack with that lead leg, throwing that beautiful sidekick that really comes out of nowhere, and it comes with such speed, Steve.
This is a great matchup. I've really been looking forward to this one.
You know, Jenny's been known, you know, primarily as a grappling specialist, but she likes to stand in the pocket and throw heavy hands. So, nice little combination there through the left leg.
Seamless transition, wasn't it? Kick, punch, kick. That's Team Lakai. She is so fluid, April Asinio. Fakes to throw the left leg, thinks about it, sends in the right instead, and then a barrage of punches. Jenny Huang hasn't faced anything of this intensity before.
Yeah, Jenny Huang is getting lit up. She has got to look to take this fight down quickly because she...
A right hand from Asinio
is
very heavy.
Asinio just get relaxed and comfortable.
And she's caught with the left leg, gets caught herself, though, a senior, but comes back with another kick, this time to the body.
Jenny's got to be careful. Can't rush in like that. Got to keep emotions out of it. Maybe tighten up her guard a little bit. Elbows are really flared out to the side, so it's going to be hard to block a lot of these body shots.
Does have that wide stance, doesn't she? As you say, elbows out to the side. But you don't know where the attack is coming from April. She's on one leg, the Filipino wrestles, ragdolls her opponent to the ground, pops back up again. Jenny Huang takes a right uppercut to the chin, and the crowd are going nuts here at the Mall of Asia Arena. Knees to the body from April Asenio. Jenny Huang looks for the takedown and gets the trip.
Nice outside trip there to get this fight onto the ground, because she was struggling there as Asenio lit her up with that clinch, landing the knees and was picking her apart on the feet. But good move by Huang to get this fight back to her area.
Just for a moment there, they looked each other in the eye about a foot apart, and Asenio decided that they would end that stare down with a punch to the face.
We've got a good fight here as these two are engaging in some pretty aggressive fisticuffs.
It was always going to be a good contest, this one. Beautifully matched by Matt Hume and his team.
Hammer fist landed by Huang from the guard.
Then goes for a straighter punch after that. April punches upwards.
Nice little ground and pound there. Good job by Huang.
She's got heavy hands when she wants to show them.
See, April's trying to get her hand fight there. Both hands are on her, on Huang's left, so she might be setting up a possible triangle, shoving that through her legs, or maybe an arm bar as well. But we've seen in the past, you know, Osenio's got some legit ground skills. You can see her throwing her legs up like that.
She's trying to catch that
attempt
right on.
That's an attempt on a submission. Look.
Don't grab the fingers, don't grab the fingers.
Uh-oh, now Huang's trying to move into side control, passes the guard. Osenio does a right thing.
Knee to the head is what she went for then. And now the guillotine.
It looks like it could be a bit onto the side. More of a neck crank, not quite a choke, but look at, listen to the ovation Osenio's getting from a guillotine.
This is how she finished Dan Osmond, and the crowd know that here at the Mall of Asia Arena. They are making a racket here at cage side, and this is a big arena.
It looks like Huang's gonna tough this out. She's doing the right thing by hand fighting there.
Still a minute to go in the first.
But she can't get distracted by throwing punches, because Osenio might get this a little bit tighter. This is how she beat Osman, so we gotta be careful. It looks like her face is going a little bit
it
blue
does,
there, but she's got it out.
She slips out.
She's
well
got
done,
it out.
Jenny Huang. That took a lot out of April Asenio. You could see the grimace on her face, the effort she was putting in, trying to secure that neck. Knees to the body from April. The trip from Jenny. Back they bounce up again.
Uh-oh, now Osenio's got double underhooks and pushes her up against the cage. Osenio trying to engage the clinch here. You think she'd create some space and go back to her bread and butter, that wushu style striking, but I think there's a grappler inside this wushu striker, Steve.
These are our preliminary contests, and they are sending everybody here through the roof.
If it's any indication of what's going to happen, let's take a look at some of this past action here. But there's that body shot, and there's just some trading of one-legged punches from both girls. There she goes, attempting the trip, muscles back out of it. Here's Jenny going with that outside trip to end up on top and spend a couple minutes there in the top position. And then we see the attempted guillotine from Osenio here. It seems to be her favorite submission as he started cranking on that neck. Looked to be more of a neck crank. But let's go to Rich Franklin. How do you break that fight down?
Well, I'll tell you the big story in the first round is the striking superiority. Obviously, April Osenio, I like what she's doing. She's mixing her takedowns up with some clinch work and throwing kicks and punches, and just everything's coming from different directions. She's the one that's really able to kind of unfold her game plan. Just a note on how we score the fight. Even though Jenny Huang scored a takedown in that first round, she's winning the takedown category, and she spent some time on top in the guard, I didn't award her any ground control points, because eventually Osenio had reversed positions and then went for the near submission. So on my scorecards, April Osenio is the one with the ground control points at this point in time.
Fascinating. And we've seen Team Lakai, Kevin Belingon in particular, show seamless transition from kicks to punches. April Asinio seems to have been watching Kevin and practicing what he preaches. First minute and a half of that round, she really was on top of her game.
You can see Jenny, whenever she flares out those elbows, it looks like she's going to strike. Even if it's just a shadow box, once she flares out the elbows, it's kind of an indication that something is going to start coming out of her. So it's a nice little tip-off for Asinio if she can pick that up. You see how the elbows kind of came up?
Uh-huh. She's very cautious, Jenny Huang, isn't she? Not inching forward at all. That's April Asinio's responsibility in this fight.
Nice little front kick there again. There's that Lakai front kick. I think we should just call it that from now on, the Lakai kick, because every single one of them do it so beautifully. I think we're going to see a few Lakai fighters on the card, so we may see that kick all night long.
Jenny Huang's game seems to be one of counterattacks because she's not pushing the attack, is she? She's waiting for April to throw first.
High time!
And no surprise that referee Olivier Coste just asked for a little bit more action in that one. Stark contrast to what happened in the first moments of the opening round. Decent kick, wasn't it, to the body from April Asinio.
She's definitely not putting the combinations the way she did together in the first round. She's only kind of throwing these one shots, but she could be setting something up here.
And she's got to be careful as well, because Jenny Huang is very dangerous.
See, that's the thing. She wants to avoid this clinch, and she wants to avoid the takedown. Beautiful outside reap there from Jenny Huang to put April Asinio onto her back. Kind of an Osoto Gotti there with a outside leg trip to end up in the top position of the side control.
Every reason to believe that the winner of this contest will have a world title bout in their very near future. A lot of big events coming up in 2017.
Good movement from the top position by Jenny Huang. She transitions from north-south to side control to take the back.
Here?
Beautifully done, Steve. Superb ground game and ground, just overall ground skills shown by Huang. Just her movement alone.
Good defense from Asinio. She's got her hands just where they need to be.
She's doing the right thing, but she looks like she could turn here. She looks like she could turn and face her and end up on top. Almost, but Jenny Huang muscles her way into the mounted position. Now Osinio's got to start moving. Now she's got to push away on those hips,
how is she gonna
create
move from
some
there?
Space. She's trying to reach out to block the hands so she didn't take any punches, but she should have put the hands on the hips and created space. And now Jenny Huang's got the back again.
Jenny Huang concentrating on getting that left arm underneath April's left arm. Is that the best way from here, Mitch? She wouldn't want to go over the top and round the throat.
She's trying to control that arm, so it's going to give her better access to the choke, because if she can secure the arm and brace it down, she's going to be able to slide that. See how she did that?
Okay.
See how she was able to slide the arm under the chin a little bit better? And that's what she wanted. But Osenio's doing the right thing by trying to scramble, but she's giving up bad positions. You can just see us, the grappling advantage is just going further and further into Jenny Huang. But a good bridge attempt there by Osinio. That's pure power to muscle out of it.
No kick, no kick.
Here looks like a possible omoplata. Able to muscle out of it from Osinio.
Osinio's got that left foot on, I beg pardon, Jenny Huang's got a left foot on Osinio's hip. She'll try and push that away, but
looks like she's setting up maybe a go-go plata here. Oh, she tapped! Oh, beautiful submission there. I don't know if you guys saw that at home. It took me a minute to catch it, but that was a go-go plata submission.
And a great celebration as well from Jenny Huang. and she has improved her record to 5-0.
Look at this from this angle. The shin is under the throat of Osenio. She's able to pull down on the back of the neck. Credit to Rich Franklin for catching that. But that was a go-go plata submission, possibly the first in ONE Championship.
We welcome our viewers from ABS-CBN. You've just joined us as April Osenio has lost in front of her home fans to Jenny Huang of Chinese Taipei.
Ladies and gentlemen, after second round, at 4 minutes and 28 seconds, your referee Olivier Costas called this fight in favor of your winner by go-go platter, Jenny Huang.
You can't knock a 5-0 record, and that's what Jenny Huang will take away from Manila with her.
Time, ready, fight!
Round one, five-minute rounds ahead of us potentially. Good start from Nunes, who connects with that left kick to the head.
This is definitely Nunes's world. She's had so much experience in the Muay Thai field that, you know, we gotta wonder at what point is Angela gonna choose to attempt to take this fight to the ground.
Right hand from Nunes with a counter blow. She's quick with those kicks upstairs, isn't she?
Yeah, but I like how Angela's immediately starting to cut the angles off of Nunez. She's got her up against the cage, eliminating the space that she's able to move around in.
Just ate a very solid jab from Nunez, and this crowd are really getting involved. Angela there, Singapore, they're shouting, forgive me. But the Singapore fighter takes another kick to the head. And Nunez is giving more than her fair share of the offense so far inside the first minute.
But the more kicks Nunez chooses to throw, it's going to get the out. That's it. There is that space, the clinch. This is where Angela usually takes fights to the ground once she gets into the clinch.
Pressing the Brazilian up against the cage wall, giving her no room to work whatsoever.
Nunez wants to frame out. She's got a frame. From the champion.
What a roar from the crowd here as that takedown put into effect.
And this is Angela's world. She's trying to pin down that arm there with that left leg as she's slowly starting to maneuver around. Nunez doing a good job of framing off with that knee, keep a little bit of space. The feet are probably going to go to the hips pretty soon. You can see her trying to slide that foot into the hip, create even more space.
Immense experience Angela Lee has, albeit just 20 years of age. Just had a little sneaky look at the elbow there, didn't work out for her.
She thought about it. You can see that now she's in the full guard of Estella. So you can see she frames underneath, she's got that underhook now on one side, she's got an overhook on the other.
Estella tries to pull her in first from the back of the head. Now just restricting the movement of Angela's arms. Keeping her close, denying her any leverage. Angela scoots around, or tries to.
Passes the guard there, Steve. That's huge. She's got past the guard, but now Estella's got her back up against the cage, and she's going to try to walk up that cage. Lee's probably going to try to scoot her around, get her back away from the cage so she can keep her there in position. Up, back into half guard. That's okay.
Elbow and then fist to the stomach from Angela Lee. More.
She's using that right, left leg of hers to kind of shield away from Angela from her to create a little bit more defensive posture. See, she's able to push away from it, trying to get back up to her feet. Angela immediately swarms on her, jumps onto her back.
And she's got
one hook in. It looks like she's got two hooks in.
Crowd absolutely roaring her on here, Mitch.
Oh, Angela's got a lot of finishes from the back. She's going to try to flatten her out. This is a bad spot for Nunez to be in.
Coming up to the final minute and a half of the opening round. Remember, there'll be five-minute rounds here.
It's important for Nunez. Oh, now here, now look at this. She's got that leg triangled around her other one and the leg underneath it. She's got it very, this is called a, she might be setting up another one of those twisters, man. Nunez's got to be real careful. Don't let that hang.
Surely not another twister.
That's what it looks like, Steve. That's it. It's in. Nunez has got a scramble. This is Angela Lee's move.
It's the signature move. Surely not in a world title defense. It looks hard. Estela Nunez doesn't look in too much this confident, apart from the fact she's taking multiple punches to the head.
She's got a limp arm out. That right arm's got a limp arm, and she's got to slide out. That's it. She's taking some shots.
This is more than a dozen blows to the head now. Angela Lee piling on the pressure. The Singapore fans roaring their hearts out for her. Estela Nunez continues to resist.
That lockdown position right there in the legs is keeping her in this position. But look at Estela Nunez.
What heart the Brazilian has.
She's got a limp arm. That right arm has got to get out from underneath the armpit of Angela Lee.
She's unable to throw anything back, just consumed with defending, and she's only got one hand to do it.
Look at the foot there, Steve. She's trying to push off with her right leg. If she can push off with the right leg and create space, that's what's keeping her.
She almost had it there. The bell saves her. Tremendous resistance from the Brazilian, but what a round from Angela Lee, and this crowd all around me on their feet going nuts.
What? Okay, so this was it. She got the overhook, she had the underhook, she used the headlock takedown to spin there. Now, once she had this fight onto the ground, it was a step-by-step process, very strategic. Here's some of that. She jumped onto the back. You can see her transition there, has that lockdown position there, triangling her legs and extending out. Keeps her pinned in that position. Once the hand of Estela Nunez, her arm rather, was behind the back of Angela Lee, Angela Lee had her pinned there and she was able to drop bombs. Rich, what do you got?
You can see the graphic there. I pulled up ground control, obviously on the ground. This was all Angela Lee. I did not award her any kind of points for the attempted submission on the twister. At the beginning of the round, I'll say this, Estela actually scored decently in the striking superiority category, so it's not like she's not on the board. This is obviously, the fight is in Angela Lee's favor at this point in time, but she hasn't created such a distance that Estela can't come back from this. Remember, this is a 5-round fight.
Yeah, 20 minutes to come. We've only seen 5. And Estela Nunez has shown us that she is here to stick around and do some damage while she does. And she starts this first round pretty much as she did, sorry, this second round pretty much as she did the first, with good hands. And Angela Lee will have to be very careful of that overhand right from Nunez, and that landed right on the button.
Estela Nunez survived the worst possible scenario. That has to have her confidence really high heading into this second round with the champion.
And remember, as Nunez sets up this attack with her fists, her real power comes from her legs. She can kick up to the head with devastating results. And Angela Lee will be mindful of that.
See, immediately Angela Lee is cutting off the angles, trying to get her pressed up against the cage. Typically, Angela doesn't like to shoot for a lot of takedowns. She gets most of her takedowns from the clinch position. So that's what Nunez has to be careful of in this next round.
It's quite clear that Angela wants the full contact. She wants to get in there close and nullify the attack that Nunez can provide in the stand-up.
The kick, went for the takedown, and delivered a knee as she was pinned up against the cage there.
More knees to the head. Estela gets up on her feet, though. Angela tries to pull her down.
She's got her in a darce choke position. One hand under the neck, the other hand laced under her arm. She's trying to snap her down, goes for the outside trip. That's an anaconda choke, Steve. Collapses beautifully in the anaconda. That's tight.
She's saying she's okay. She's giving Olivier Costa the thumbs up. Tremendous resistance again from Estela Nunez.
Right there, she has to frame off her hands, create a little bit of space with that right arm. So the arm is, she's essentially getting choked with her own arm.
She's still giving Olivier the thumbs up. Tremendous resistance from the Brazilian, but Angela Lee's attack is furious.
Look at Nunez, her head is pressed up against the side there of Angela Lee. Angela Lee has both arms nice and tight, but there is space for Nunez to breathe. Her right arm is not completely tight to her back.
I think she's done it. She's done it. It couldn't last forever. Angela Lee has made her second successful defense of a world title. The tears are already falling. She's done it again. The roar around me at the Singapore Indoor Stadium is deafening. Into the arms of her father, Ken Lee, who's coached her since she was a young girl. And the emotion is evident for all to see. The resistance from Estela Nunez was strong. And right up until the very final moment, it looked like it was going to continue. But there's the relief, a picture for all of Singapore to look at and be proud. Christian Lee, her brother, giving her a hug. Mitch, take us through these final moments. Rich Franklin is with us as well. Rich, just take us through these final moments.
I tell you, it's just to watch Angela Lee do this. I mean, she's been able to pull off an anaconda, a twister, guillotine chokes, arm bars. It's crazy. And it, you know, you saw her prior to this actually working the snap down, trying to earn that takedown. And then she was set in this kind of anaconda choke position from the standing position the whole time, and ended up working it to the trip where she earned that position. It's just amazing to see the different angles that she's able to work various submissions from. She's always looking for something.
Well, Dom Lau has the official decision, and you can bet that it is going to be met with rapturous cheers from the crowd here in Singapore.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the belt for this bout, we have Mr. Roger Chen, GoDaddy's Vice President of Asia. And now, your referee, Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this fight after 2 minutes and 18 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of anaconda choke, and still one women's atomweight champion of the world, unstoppable Angela Lee.
Estela Nunez falls to 5-1. The champion Angela Lee improves to 8-0. She screams at the camera. Victor Kui has the honor of putting that belt around her waist. She retains her title. The confetti comes down from the skies. We're drenched in it here at Cageside and are happy to be so.